Welcome back to the fifth eviction of Big Brother 2009. So far, Halfwit has been seen off. He's seen off Sophia, he's KO'd Kyron, he's annihilated Angel, and tonight he has taken on Shree. Will he live to fight another day? Well, the results are in, and I'm now going to talk to the house. Big Brother House, this is Davina. You are live on Channel 4. Please do not swear. Halfwit.
Yes.
And Shree, the lines are closed. The votes have been counted and verified. And I can now reveal that the fifth person to be evicted from the Big Brother House is.
Good luck, guys.
Shree! Shree, it's now time for you to say your goodbyes. I'm coming to get you!
It's alright, don't worry.
Mom.
Good luck, man.
Sorry, sorry. Right.
My new job is waiting.
Shree?
I'm waiting for it. Don't worry. You did well, man. Still, I can't get you.
Yep.
Very good luck.
Good luck, darling.
I'm like 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shree, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house. Shree, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house. Shree,
Elvis the King left the building.
Please leave the Big Brother house.
TV rock royalty and massive Big Brother fan, Kelly Osbourne, and body language expert, Judy James. So, Shree, I always think it must be such a rude awakening to be thrown out of the house and suddenly here you are and all those people booing out there. What was that like?
See, it's a part of achievement. For me, winning or losing is not important. Participation and representation is really good, important. And it's a really practical life experience. And personally, me, person who comes next week or week after or till end to the show is not a winner or a loser. They have a very good time, good experience, because the Big Brother is a program, is a worldwide, publicized, very good event. So enough people try to apply, millions, thousands of people
so
from different parts of...
Just to get through, through that and to be sat here, have taken part.
Yeah, taking initiation part and as long as be yourself and had a good time with different housemates.
Shree, yesterday you and Marcus had a big row and Marcus was called in by Big Brother and given his first official warning because of
the language that he used and the threatening language that he used. What's up with you and Marcus? Where are you now?
Me, personally, I'm still in a different world. The thing is, right, Marcus is a kind of fellow housemate. Very first two days, it's really strange to understand him and cope with him, to link up with him. Maybe it's like a different cross-cultural, different backgrounds and different wide areas. Because I'm a 25-year-old, come to England to pursue my master's degree, and all of a sudden I become the president of the Students' Union.
We know that.
And
we do know that, don't we? Because he's told us a lot.
And me, I cope all the time with students a lot, more than elder people. So all of a sudden...
Do you think he was too old? You couldn't relate to him?
No, it's not about the age. It's all about the, like, living in the same house with different people. I used to live with different students and stuff like that. Personally, he's a quite aggressive person. Enough times, enough occasions, he do use all the time a swear language. And personally...
Well, you did quite a bit of swearing.
No. Me personally, look, at certain point of stage, I do use only when I really stressed out, only F this, F that. But personally, he do use so many times with the production team and stuff.
Listen.
And he do argue with me all this time, and I was really shopping list.
I'm gonna talk to you a bit more about the swearing and the shopping list and everything in a moment. Mm. But I just wanted to quickly bring Kelly in because Marcus, we know, had an issue with you. You had an issue with him. But somebody who doesn't have an issue with you is Kelly. Tell us what you think, Shree.
I think, to be totally honest with you, because you come from such a different culture to here, that it really reminded me of the movie Lost in Translation. That they just didn't understand your background, and it's no fault to them and it's no fault to you. But I have to say that your biggest problem is that you don't know when to shut up.
Yes.
And you know, I really had to learn that lesson the hard way.
Where did that manifest itself?
You're just here now.
All the time. And you know, I mean, you got 85% of the vote, which is quite high. Which is quite high. And I know that that's... I mean, why do you think the public disliked him? Just for that? No.
Do you know... No, I don't think it's just for that. I think it's a number of reasons. I can't stress enough the, like, Lost in Translation thing. But you're also dealing with a lot of ego and a lot of personality clashes, and you're going to be allergic to some people. It's just life. But instead of finding out, instead of going, why don't you like me, why don't you like me, and trying to force people and talk people into liking you, you should have just gone, and walked away. You know, you should have done what Lisa does.
Listen, I want to talk to you about nominations. Mm. So I'm just going to quickly show them to you.
He is disrespectful, two-faced, does not deal with problems directly, but rather bitches behind people's back. And he's playing games with people because he's scared of facing the public vote.
He quite, you know, annoys me sometimes when the way he says, speak really loud, speak over people. He doesn't let us to complete our sentence. He just speak over. And I had enough of this subject, Noreen, 24 hours a day.
A lot of people are soft on him, you know, because he does do the 15-year-old kid act and, you know, then he pretends, you know, he does the stupid act and he pretends he doesn't understand and gets the sympathy vote.
I've had friends like that before. They're like frenemies. They try to keep you sweet and they use you for things that they want. It's like you keep your friends close but your enemies even closer. Like, that's what I feel like he's doing with me.
I do honestly believe that he does have sort of a game plan and he does try to, like, keep everyone sweet all the time. Then he flips at them and then as soon as, like, around nomination, he goes and trying to kiss and make up with them.
Did you have a strategy?
No. if we do have any strategy, I need to work it out right now. It will be utilised for next time.
I mean, Judy, even though he didn't actually maybe have a strategy consciously, do you think he maybe had one subconsciously?
I was so interested because you went in on a really safe meal ticket in that house. For a long time, you went in amazingly for a 25-year-old man, but you were the house baby. And everybody kept saying, he's like my annoying little brother.
Yes.
And you were annoying people, but the wonderful thing was they were tolerating you and actually liking you. Now, when you take the role of house baby, you don't get attacked. People don't nominate you because it would make them look bad. So it was a very safe role for you to have. And in animal terms, this is called pseudo-infantile remotivating techniques, which is when... You want that one again?
Go on.
And what it is, when a smaller animal feels under threat or attack from a larger animal, it will often display like a baby animal, with the idea being that the larger animal sort of thinks, well, I can't attack a baby, and so it will go off and kill somebody else. So you were so safe on that. You were good fun. You kept running to Lisa, who was your mummy, but it was just quite pleasant, and you were genuinely safe at that stage.
And actually, this week, we saw Shree's behaviour change, and in response, the housemate's behaviour changed. I'm just going to show a quick example of this. Let's have a look at this.